Steve Hare with NCEW Life. We have Norm Tupling joining us right now. Norm is a Mansfield resident who is now a candidate running for a seat on the Douglas County Commission to represent District 3. Norm, thanks for joining us here.
Thanks for having me.
Well, let's talk about your campaign and a little bit about yourself. And again, you're a Mansfield native, so.
That's correct.
Small town boy?
Yes.
Okay.
Very small.
So let's talk about that life in Mansfield and basically why you've decided to run.
So the reason that I'm decided to run is because of our district. It's a unique district.
Mm-hmm.
It's very rural, the most of it, you know. Some of it includes a little bit of East Wenatchee. And I just feel that we need representation for up there, for that part of the district, that part of the county.
Do you feel it's lacking in representation right now?
You know, with Steve Jenkins on there, he's been a pretty good representation for that end. But I feel like if we don't have someone from up in that area that's familiar with the area, familiar with the needs, and familiar with the people, then it can become a lacking deal, yes.
What kind of issues are really driving your campaign, especially as it relates to District 3? What kind of issues are they facing right now?
So one of the issues is road maintenance. As you know, we have a lot of rural roads. And for us in that area, it's an important thing because that's the infrastructure for our economy up there.
Mm-hmm.
It's agriculture, and we need good infrastructure to ship our product.
It occurs to me that the last major capital project that occurred out there was the replacement of the Chief Joe Bridge in Bridgeport, correct?
Yeah, the one that goes up towards Pearl Hill.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a major project. Boy, they underwent a big one there.
Yeah.
And it was an important one because we have a lot of grain that comes off of that hill.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go again. It's a big deal for us.
Well, Douglas County is kind of an interesting situation, dynamic there, especially as you look at how the county is structured. It's a large county, but a lot of the issues, I think, are kind of concentrated in that East Wenatchee area. A lot of that's where the population core of the county is, and certainly there are issues that need to be addressed in mostly that northern county area that you want to represent.
We do, and one of them, like I said, is the road maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
Because we need it. We rely on it for our livelihood up there. And then the other I am concerned with is our school safety. And I think that touches the whole county, not just the rural, but our small schools. Our sheriff's department offers a program for active shooter training to come into the schools and train them and teach them and educate them on some of this stuff. And I think it's important that our schools get on board with it.
How do you think the county board of commissioners can work closer with the school to do that?
Just reaching out to them, I think, and expressing the importance of the training and how, you know, yeah, we live in a rural area and our schools are small, but we can't have our heads in the sand, per se.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we need to be thinking about it because it can happen anywhere. We don't want it to, but it can.
Okay, how long have you been farming wheat up in the Mansfield area?
So I worked for Douglas County PUD as a journeyman lineman, and then in 2012, I quit the PUD to start farming full time. And it's been fun. It's been interesting and fun at the same time.
Well, you're in the thick of things right now with the world situation. The wheat growers, I'm sure, are also a little have a little trepidation about what's occurring worldwide with this trade war.
We do. You know, 90%, give or take, is of our product is shipped overseas. So trade is a big deal for us.
Yeah, obviously, but eating to your bottom line. Let's talk about some other issues that are pertinent, of course, to Douglas County residents, affordable housing being one of them. Are you well-versed on that issue?
Well, I'm not an expert on it by any means, but you know, we do need affordable housing because we need housing available to the people that are working in the county.
Mm-hmm.
And as our county grows, we want to provide jobs. Well, if we provide jobs, we got to have a place to put the people live. And if they can't afford it, there's a problem. And so somehow we've got to find some balance there with the cost of the housing, because you have a property, you know, say you have a property owner, well, he owns a property and somebody comes along, offers them an extreme amount of money for it. You can't fault the property owner. He owns it.
That's right.
And so it's, you know, his choice to do what he wishes with it. But at the same time, we got to find some kind of balance to get some affordable housing for people.
Of course, there's a lot of land, a lot of rural land out in that third district of Douglas County, and certainly it's an area that could be developed. Certainly, we have a Growth Management Act that the state enforces. Does that cause any problems for your district? I know that there are times when people like to sell off their land for development, but there are some constraints there. How does that affect your guys?
Well, there are, because of the way it's zoned, and zoning it helps the agriculture industry. It helps keep taxes down. Well, it helps everybody. I mean, it helps with taxes and stuff, and it helps our agriculture community with having it zoned that way. So it's, but there again, it's kind of a tricky issue, because as a property owner myself, I mean, if I own the property, I should have the choice to do what I want with it. Mm-hmm. I shouldn't have somebody telling me, no, you can or you can't do. I mean, the whole idea is you own the property. Not the government shouldn't be telling you what you can and can't do with it.
So basically, those private property rights issues are at play there.
Yes, very much. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. Anything else you'd like to talk about in terms of what you see as important priorities for you if you're elected?
Well, one of the things I can just say is that I bring a unique aspect to the commissioners. You know, we have Steve is retiring, and so we have two others, Kyle and Dan, on there. And I feel like I can really contribute to them and to our county with just having a knowledge of the county. Having been here my entire life, I know the county, I know my district really well. And so I can bring that to the table for them. You know, maybe there might be a certain area that they're kind of maybe lacking in or knowing, and I can bring that and help them to understand some of the needs of our area too.
Tell us a little bit about your family.
So I have a wife and a daughter. We got married in 2005, and we have a 7.5-year-old daughter, and she currently goes to school in Mansfield, same place I did. And they love our county too. And so I would like to, if I can contribute and serve and give back to the county that's given to me, then I'm doing good.
Well, fantastic. Well, we wish you the best of luck in your endeavors here. Again, we've been talking with Norm Buck Tupling, a great nickname, by the way.
Thank you.
And he's seeking your vote as commissioner of Douglas County District 3. Thanks for joining us here on NCW Life. I'm Steve Hare.